Good evening. Yeah, I'm going to talk on in this series something which is mental health oriented, okay? Not everything about the disease, you know, because we all go through a life cycle, and the life cycle that we go through keeps on having a lot of responsibility, okay? And this responsibility at a time keep causing some troubles of and some advantages, okay? So in today's era, when we are becoming urban, the urban, my PhD is rather urban mental health, you know, everything is probably a problem, you know. Basically, it's a congestion, it's a trauma, you know, there are lack of resources, it's a trauma. So what we are going to look at children and parents, the sandwiched adults. I, being a medical educationist also, I use the sandwich model in the teaching to the medical teachers, okay? So, what are we looking at? Remember that children and parents, adult children is caring adult children. Can you digest this word? Adult children, okay? Is caring for their aging parents while dealing with their own children. I have my parents and I have my children, okay? So this is in between, is a children, adult of the parents behind, you know, and is a parent of children, you know, ahead. So it is adult children, okay? And this term is coined by social worker Dorothy Miller in 1981, and that is called as a sandwich generation, okay? The generation in between the two generations, right? Next. So what is sandwich generation? It is a middle-aged individuals who are pressured to support both aging parents and growing children, okay? So that's the reason why it is called sandwich generation. It is named so because they are effectively sandwiched between the obligation to care for aging and children, okay? So they are literally dealing in between the two era. Next. So we all like to be nice, Santa Claus, okay? We want to make people happy, you know, just give happiness to my friend, to my mother, to my father, to my child, you know? And then, you know, in whole situation where you want to be real Santa, you know, there are troubles because we are agreeable and accommodating. Now that is important for us to know because we are talking to about the sandwich generation. Next. So sandwich adults, what are the pressures, which is very important? What are the pressures, okay? The problem faced by the members of sandwich generation have received increasing publicity. People are talking about it, okay? And because there are, and the generation, the next and the generation behind, I'm coming to it, it's not easy as it used to be before, okay? If you are feeling the pressure of looking after your parents and your kids, you are not alone. Okay, I mean, I shouldn't feel, why am I sandwich? Why am I, you know, poor sandwich? Okay, so today around 2.4 million Britons are part of what is known as a sandwich generation. Same is in US, same is in developing country, okay? In fact, developing countries are going to face this problem because of their vast population, and that's China and India both. Modern world, increases in life expectancy coupled with delays in starting a family. Nowadays, the people live 80 years. I mean, because I am expecting myself to live around 80, 85, okay? And I don't know, I am going to be a burden on whom, okay? Then, of late, the generation which you are coming, you know, you want to achieve something, career, you know? So children are not early, okay? Children little later. That's a trick, basically, and that's this time trick which creates the hassle, because by the time your children start going, before that your parents are aging, okay? So you are literally locked in, okay? And these are the modernization issues, because previously 23-24 ho gaya to shaadi karo, 25-26 ho gaya to bachcha chahiye. Okay, I mean that was normal. Today 30 tak bachche ho jate hain, and by that time apne parents bhi bahut bade hote hain, right? So they are aging already. So a quarter of the UK's population have experienced sandwich caring at some point. They find it difficult to plan their own future. For a mother, you know, or for the caretaker, aaj you cannot do, you know, jumping or aggressive career building because you have children. They need to be settled. And then when you become 50, 52, and there are opportunities to grow a little further, but you can't do it because you have aging parents. And that's the reason why we really need to understand, you know, this particular sandwich adults. Next. Yeah. It doesn't necessarily stop when the kids leave school. चलो बच्चों का स्कूल खत्म हो गया, टेंथ खत्म हो गया, नाउ आई एम कंफर्टेबल. ऐसे नहीं होता है, यू नो, बिकॉज यू आर नॉट कंफर्टेबल इन द डिमांड्स ऑफ द लाइफ इन अर्बन मेट्रोपोलिस आर टू मेनी. इफ यूर चिल्ड्रन लैग बिहाइंड, नाउ दिस इज द एरिया वेर आई गेट सो मेनी पेशेंट्स, आई मीन सो मेनी फोन कॉल्स टेलिंग द दैट माई चाइल्ड इज क्राइंग, माई चाइल्ड इज नॉट लुकिंग, यू नो, एट द एग्जाम इज कमिंग इन, यू नो. सो with it getting together to get on the career and property ladder, more than a quarter of adults aged 20 to 34 are still living at home. In our country, we are not like Americans. We are not yet individualistic country. We are yet family integrated, socially integrated country. So we live together. You understand that still we live together. The children after 18 also are with parents, and the aging parents are with their children who are adults. Okay, so this is the scenario. So transition. So as our children get older, they move away and transition from being dependent to independent. Okay, so that is a transition of the children. But what happens to elder generation, which is elder to us? Now they were independent so far, but as the age advancing from independently, because they have medical disorders, they have psychiatric disorder, they have something called as a dementia, behavior problems. So now from that independence, they are coming to be dependent. So the adult, you know, who is a sandwich, right now just getting relieved because children are becoming independent, but not so relieved because parents are becoming dependent. Okay, so you are, you know, actually at the crossroad. Okay, so there is an overwhelming stress as caregiver. New improvements in geriatric care are ensuring that people are living longer. Okay, like I come from a absolutely prime institute in the country. In fact, the geriatric care, which is started first in KM. Okay, and now, you know, basically dementia case, when it used to come, I used to call my students running, dekho, you know, the dementia case has come, the Alzheimer case has come, now you see all the symptoms and try to understand. But today I don't have to do that. I don't have to keep calling the students for simple reason that there are so many geriatric patients keep coming in. So many patients, you know, with dementia. I mean, we in my OPD daily we see at least one case of dementia. So it's that common. So every student get to see. So that is, remember that I'm a public health PhD person. You have to always understand, you know, how the whole scenario of developing city or developing nation keeps changing. And that's what we are now. You know, the upper part of our development is elderly population, the 50 plus. See, life expectancy, which was 58, then 62, is increased now. Okay? And that's the reason why we see the transition. And that means that adult children often carry this burden decades longer than their parents or grandparents. Like my parents, they had their parents who were little more healthy, they didn't live so longer. My both the parents were 80 plus. My mother just touched 80 at the time of death. Okay, and then I see my colleagues around, all of us have the same story. We literally have, you know, put in so many efforts, you know, to take care of aging parents. Okay, because we have seen them. Like for me, my parents never suffered throughout their life, but both of them, they suffered 2 to 3 years before their death with the medical illness, medical complications, and it was extremely, you know, difficult to cope up. For me, when I was a dean at that time in KM, it was so much guilt for me that when I am reaching at home while parents are ill, because I used to reach home every day by 8 o'clock, okay? So this is what we need to understand. Types of sandwiches which you go to the Irani hotel or the, I miss Irani hotels because they used to be near my house and I always ate the sandwich, you know, the cheese sandwich or the, you know, but there are sandwiches which are typology in the this generation, and that is what? Traditional adult sandwich between aging parents and need, you know, and who need care and our help and their own children. So I need to invest my energy in my child and my parents. So that's a traditional. The club sandwich, adults in their 50s or 60s, sandwich between aging parents, adult children and grandchildren, generations. Okay, the 50 and 60 is a little difficult because you have so many generation and that's a club sandwich, you know, too many layers. Okay, too many layers because you have your parents, you sometimes have a little grandparents, or you have your son and you have that grandchild. So 4 generation. So that's club sandwich. Okay, and then open anyone else involved in the care. So the feeling in between can be mousy, kaka, chachi, you know, sister, anybody. So that's you should know because this may happen in coming generations. Next, so economical constraint, it's very important. Okay, basically, you know, what is important if you can afford. You know, the I am involved with so many old age homes because there are some good old age homes. And if you want, you know, your ailing parent to get best care and you don't want to burn out within yourself, okay? So what you need to send them to these houses, and there is nothing emotional about you. You really need a good care, but then you need good money. If you want to get some, you know, somebody to look after, so now the, you know, how much the elder care nurse charge per day around 800 to 1200 depending on the situation. So that kind of charges and that kind of maintenance is troublesome because, you know, it requires the economy. Aggravated the problem faced by adult children caring for their parent, since their children may require help as well. I mean, nowadays it's not easy, you know, even in the medical, it's not easy. After medicine, the parents want their children to appear for NEET and then appear for the post graduation. Then, you know, my students now talk about super specialty. Okay, so I was just asking an intern, what are you planning to do? He said, madam, I want to become neurologist. That means MD and then post MD. Okay, so the parents still have to support. See, in my system, we give good salary, but not in the private medical college. And the thing is that there is always a feeling that this child must do well. Okay, if he doesn't become super specialist, the life will be difficult. Okay, young adults between the ages of 25 to 35 you live with their parents in our country. Okay, I mean in America they walk out, you know, they have already the girlfriend, they have live-in relationship. It's coming in the city also, but still they don't walk out. I mean in the city like Mumbai, Kolkata, Delhi, Bangalore, it's not easy to find out a separate house and start living your young life, you know, independently with the pressure of money. So the economical burden, the budget will always be issue, you know, and that will be a more of a sandwich generation because, you know, kisko dekho, no, idhar jao ya udhar jao. You understand that yahan mere maa baap hai, yahan mere bachche hai. So that's a whole important thing which is very squeeze. Finding yourself squeeze between and often by these two generation can be very stressful. Kyunki wo to seedha simple sa jhagda to ghar mein hota hai. TV dekhne ke liye, nana nani ko kuch dekhna hai aur bachchon ko kuch dekhna hai. So this becomes a very very important perspective, you know, for the people because you are squeezed in between their demands, their likes, their requirements, their resources. Okay. Emil Holzhausen, Director of Policy and Public Affairs at Carers in UK, say, I always point at public health because that's what my interest is. I had been in the administration and with the municipal corporation doing all this. Okay. Juggling works and caring responsibilities isn't easy, so try not to add to the pressure by feeling bad about what you are doing, because there is a huge guilt. Main justice kar raha hu ye generation se wo generation se, when I start, you know, investing my time in my children because it's their future, I feel guilty. Am I not looking at my parents? Okay, so that juggling pressure is terrible. Next. Facing time pressure, this is a very important, you know. If you need to take time off work to look after a relative, flexible working arrangements will be useful, which is not still in India. You know, working from home is not a very common, though I see in some of the popular companies in, you know, my sister worked from home, you know, with a huge multinational company because they allowed it. Okay, so she could look after, you know, her child, and there was everything provided. But this is not possible, you know, to work with the flexible hours, because you have to go 9 to 5, you know, you have to work like that. And then that's a tough time, you know, you see the people getting depressed. I see women getting depressed, ki, you know, my father is at home, I must go, madam, please don't make me wait, because, you know, the dean's office, we always ask people to wait. Next, secure finance. First thing, you know, I'm a psychiatrist, and why, what am I talking? But remember that the mental health hugely depends on how secure people in terms of their resources are. And that's the reason why the poverty brings in a huge mental health problem. I mean, that's what we have studied. My whole study, or, you know, at the Harvard, Arthur Kleinman has studied in China, you know, who happened to be my guide also, you know, with Dr. Weiss. And we have found the mental health and poverty goes a very important aspect. So we have to have the tax efficient ways which are coming. You know, the companies are talking about this, to use saving and investment to generate income to help towards the cost of additional support. I mean, people are talking. I do listen to CNBC, you know, how to invest money, because if you have no other way of money, how to make money out of your own money and make the life comfortable is important. And that's the psychology, you know. Investment, remember, is not just the money, it's not just the economy, it is psychology. And if I have to look at my old age, I must need to look at that. Next. Health, the physical and emotional health of the sandwich generation naturally tends to decline. The blood pressure, diabetes, absolutely is in this generation. You know, the range keeps increasing. That's what you see in the population data. And giving up work to care for an elderly parent is simply not a viable option. I would like to tell people, don't do that. Okay, you know, if you earn, actually you get the time, you know, to be independent, to be dynamic, and that's very important. So that is what people, if they do, that's not really a nice option to do. The importance of providing advice and support to sandwich generation carers on how to plan financially and otherwise makes a very important perspective. Since caring for my parent deserves some quotes, you know, from narrative of the people. Since caring for my parent, my enjoyment of sexual activity has been, they keep awake, you know, so has been, and then you try to understand what it can be. Okay, since caring for my parent, my marital relationship has been, and there are dramas, you know, Marathi theater has got good dramas, you know, on this particular issue. So fantastic. I mean, they have depicted this particular aspect in a beautiful dramas, you know, very high level dramas easily. Then well-being matters. Providing sandwich care can also negatively affect the emotional well-being of carers, feeling guilty, feeling depressed. Okay, with little time to socialize, carers lack the means of respite from their caring responsibilities. It's very important, you know, respite care. I feel, comfortable at times. I'm tired and I need to look at some movie. I need to look at, you know, to walk around the garden. I need to look at, to have the break and go to Lonavala for 2-3 days. That break is required. It can be financially costly. I mean, so much money already invested in children and in the parents. Where do I get money? But respite care, don't even forget this word, matters to preserve, you know, your energy, your motivation, preventing you are burnt out. Okay, the well-being, you know, people unable to plan financially and sandwich generation feeling unsupported in their role. You feel alone, you know, you don't have anybody. And today it is more important because only one child, okay, only two child, the one is gone to America, you know, you are alone here. You know, if both gone to America, you are alone here. And that's where we really need to look at, because this is a situation today. All my colleagues, you know, have one child, you know, and then they, if they send to America, most of the, you know, and then they have the, their parents, it's a very difficult, tough issue. It is emotional energy. Okay, so support groups are very important. I believe having good friends in the life, maybe 2-3 makes a difference. It makes a life absolutely beautiful heaven. You know, you don't have to have the crowd as a friend. You should have good friends and it makes life heaven. I mean, fortunately, I have some. Though I have the critical people also, I didn't bother about them much. I went with my own things, but the friends have helped a lot, okay? Then, worse for adult children dealing with the parents and other relatives suffering from dementia. It's bad anyway, but if it is dementia, it's worse for the sandwich generation. Because, you know, you are dealing anyway with such a kind of stress, you know, and dementia, they have found it's tough, okay? And only they become worse with the time. Why these are difficult? Because your parents, they don't become better. They become worse. So your investment of energy is more and more and more, and it doesn't stop. Okay? And in our society, in our culture, you feel bad to thinking that how you know bad it is, how burdensome it is for me to go through, because you feel guilty. You are not supposed to talk like that about your parents. But the burden keeps increasing and only become worse with times, is a major burden with a few real alternatives. If there is a money, yes. There are, I mean, my two friends, you know, two sisters who stay in America of my age, their mother 90 plus is in a good, you know, old age home. But that's a rarity, and then one after other keeps, you know, keeps coming within 6 months time. But again, it needs huge money, yeah. So to conclude, the sandwich generation is growing. Looking at the way system, you know, of our urban, probably areas are increasing, you know, we see every day, it's a population explosion, you know, and the population explosion in the city like Mumbai is not the higher level population, it's a restricted economy level population. So the burden is going to increase. The need to have so many outlets to take care for this sandwich generation is also increasing, okay? And that's the reason why we really need to look at, because it will have the impact on the work. Like for example, I know the people whose promotions are missed because they couldn't. Okay, they couldn't because of the household burden. It is the burden on the valet, and most caregivers make career adjustment. It's unfortunate, but you know, the people generally, since as I told you, it is not an individualistic society, I just don't think of myself. I think about those who are dependent on me, and then you compromise with your career. Okay, so the opportunities are minimized, and out of this, if you will look at the gender, women are affected more because they are 24 hours caretaker, and many women who are housewives, they are not paid for that caretaking. You understand that? And they really work hard. Like for example, I asked some of my colleagues that so far you have taken care of, I'm a writer basically, so I am in the literature a lot last 10 years. That's another area I search for myself, because I never wanted to get just trapped in psychiatry. One life, you have to do whatever you enjoy. Okay, and when I talk to some of these people, that are you not tired? Because as soon as the children get married, the women are ready to become grandmother. And I say, why don't you take your time out, go with your friends, enjoy a little bit, you know? But they do emotionally. Why can't they do that, you know? Why just go, you know? I think Kesari tours and so many tours available, go to Himalaya, spend time. But before even they understand of the one trap, they are already in another trap. And I'll tell you, as you grow older, opportunities of enjoying like this will be reduced. So it's better to be active today when I don't have arthritis, you know, when my heart is functioning well, when there is no diabetes, let me jump in Himalaya, let me go somewhere, let me do something. You know, the women in the country need to learn that, you know, when would they enjoy the life as an individual human being, and which is very important, because these are some of the important issues in sandwich generation, sandwich adult children. Don't forget the word adult children. You know, all of you are going to be today adult, but you are going to be adult children when the parents at one end and the children at other end. So we have to be ready for that. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Parkar, for making us aware about the difficulties faced by the sandwich generation and some tips they can use to take care of themselves. And as you said, all of us will be sandwich generation at one or the other point in our life. We can take the questions.
Yes.
Ma'am, as you were told about sandwich generation, like as caregivers, like as psychologists,
We would be taking care of our parents, we would be having kids, and then we have this additional thing as psychologist or psychiatrist that we are taking care of people who are coming to us. So they would be coming with issues. So it would be emotionally and mentally draining. So how do you say, how to deal with that?
You and I, we come from the same behavior science. And I actually can talk because I have taken care of my parents. It's a very difficult, my mother was 7 months hospitalized for the dialysis. And you know, I have given up my dean post, but not, it was a career compromise, because I got a national project with the 7 states. So I weighed my situation, and I always believed, do what you enjoy. But remember that you and I are human beings, but we are little better human beings because we understand the nitty-gritty of the emotional turmoil, okay, which other people don't understand. And we may have the access to the friends. I have the best access to my friends, which were supportive, and the burden is going to come, okay? However, we are still better because, and you will be still better than me, because by the time your parents will be old, you will have the support system in the environment which we need to track today. Like for example, if I wanted to catch a nurse, I really needed to find out how good she is. But today when I find, you know, there are good nurses and people are getting. So as the generation goes ahead, we will have a good home care takers ready, because they are being trained in the city, okay? And remember that as a mental health professionals, we must believe we have little more understanding of ourselves than other people, so we can help more, you know, in terms of many issues in our area. And of course, the economy is becoming strong. A few years back in my time, I never understood what is mutual funds. Today, I have invested in this because I know, and I'm securing my budapa with my, you know, and I don't have the next generation. But it is tough. It was tough for me. I worked as a dean, and I always used to work as academic dean, and it was tough for me. In KM, it's not easy with my parents falling ill, you know. But I'll tell you, because it was a huge system, the whole KM was with me, you know, while taking care. So I was blessed.
So it is, the first thing is that you take care of yourself and then you take care of
me. I believe in that. You have to take care of yourself. I mean, I tell like every dean the same thing. You know, you have to invest in yourself before you do and talk big, you know, basically.
Ma'am, is it okay like to leave our parents' home? Because somewhere it's like this tradition and modernity.
Leave your parents, say that?
Sorry?
Leave your parents?
No, no, leave the parents' home. Huh. Like for even if we are in the same city, just as in modern, I don't know, modern is not the right word.
Yes. I have written articles on this. I have written articles in Marathi and I have written articles in the very critical journals. I didn't leave my parents' home, but if the things would have been bad with me, suppose if I would have had the heart problem or the blood pressure, you know, I cannot burn out myself. As a human being, remember that you have to give your best possible. And the word is the best possible commitments to your relatives, okay? And if you are ill and not in the, you know, in the capacity of giving a good care, and if they can get a good care somewhere else, why not? It is just a matter of thinking how best can you do. See, that guilt which you get if you're trying to throw out your parents, but it is not throwing out your parents, it is putting your parents in the best care. Okay, that is the judgment. You know, I have spoken to so many of my colleagues because this issue comes, and this issue comes with a, you know, absolute cultural blindness. You know, loving your parent, yes, you love them. Okay, but they getting best care, you have to do your best. I mean, if I am not there and I keep my parents at home with the people who don't even care, I mean, I hired people, I don't know how to, then sending them, there is nothing wrong in that because you are trying to give best to your parents.
Ma'am, can you dwell with more about the solution part? Like, apart if somebody doesn't have a proper support group, like you were blessed to have a support group. On that context, how would somebody sort out the problem?
You know, so many people, the generations have become smaller now. I mean, this is something which I am finding at this juncture. So how worse it is going to be 25 years later is to be imagined. But in this situation, remember, I use the word respite care. So when you take care, I have a experience of my sister being in Tata Memorial, you know, for years, and that was a time I was progressing, okay. But in this particular situation, doing something and being alert about your own existence matter a lot, because you can't be emotionally blind. You know, to the level of falling sick. I have seen people falling sick. I have seen people getting infarction. I have seen people getting ischemic heart diseases simply because they didn't care. You know, like I have kept awake with my sister for 4-5 night. On the sixth day, I literally needed the sleep. Okay, now these are the signals of the body. Okay, see, the world is reality and not the imagination, not the fantasy, and we have to be careful. And remember that if you are not selfish, if you are not harming the person around, you have to do what best you can do for yourself and for others. That is, you know, that is the reality.
So I'm also a sandwich generation, but unfortunately my parents have passed away. Hello?
Yeah.
Hello? Hello? Yeah. So, and at that time my children were young, and that time I was also younger, so maybe I had the energy. But today I can see a lot of my friends and colleagues, their parents are 90 plus. Minimum age of my friend's parents is 85 plus. Now, from your lecture, I especially came to attend your lecture because I'm writing a film exactly on this subject. I'm from the media. The thing is, what I really liked is, one is what you mentioned is, do not have any guilt around this particular caretaking process. That is, if you feel you need to keep your parents somewhere else, you go ahead and do it. The second thing I found interesting is, and which should be brought into being, is low cost old home, because you mentioned, which is true, that putting the anybody in a home per se involves a lot of money. And then what happens to people who are not so economically, you know, who cannot do it? So low cost homes, is that another solution which you feel is?
See, low cost home is a solution, but what we need, you know, more than the cost, you know, we should be, do we have, and unfortunately, we don't have the skilled people to take care. I mean, that's my worry, because today, I know there will, and I'm sure you also, you are from media, there are huge, I mean, well-known people had been in the old age homes, and the thing is that there wasn't a kind of care. Okay, low cost, yes, because America has got, there is something called as a social security, you know, and they are, see, I had done my PhD in Switzerland. At that juncture, the place where I was staying, opposite it, there was a old age home, you know, and I used to visit that pretty often, okay, and it is done, you know, basically because that social security comes from the government, but Switzerland is a very rich country, richest in the world, you know. Germany there have been, I mean, I have seen this because years I was staying with them, you know, for a year and for 6 months, and I used to see that. Now that kind of responsibility by the policy makers or the government sector yet is a dream, but if it gets fulfilled, and I don't know how, with the kind of, you know, we are a massive population. You know, whatever you do in this country is going to be still less, okay, but that is there, or otherwise we really need, I just look at the women, you know, jo ki maine kafi women ko encourage kiya, wo jaake bartan majti hai, jhadu pota karti hai, so I told them, why not get into the caretaking business, where you perhaps will take a good money elegantly. Okay, so this is, I think, if we look at our country, we need to align, you know, the kind of resources which we have in terms of thinking, how do we go about it.
And also, what do you recommend for people, old people, who are still physically and mentally fit, but have a, you know, small ailments? And how can they occupy themselves? You know, we had an earlier lecture where Dr. Bharat Shah mentioned some classes, etc. But beyond that, do you have any other solution?
No, I do have a solutions. Like, for example, you know, you see, like I have seen the cadre, the higher cadre of bureaucrats. You know, they work till the age of 75, 76. Their knowledge and their expertise is being invested because they are on this commission, that commission. Now, people with the lower level, you know, it is not possible. You know, basically because I was talking to my commissioner, can something be done about that? But yes, still, this generation who is retiring is well-versed, well-knowledgeable. If they can, you know, still use on the contract basis systems like you know, KM, the huge budget, you know, I used to have tough time, you know, looking at that budget. So such a people can be hired post-retirement and still they work because their intellectual ability is good, their expertise is good till the level they feel tired. After that, of course, people can do something which they always wanted to do but they could not do. No.
And maybe some classes specially for the caretakers.
Yes.
Because caretakers are, yes, the most affected people, and they, I feel they definitely,
very much, very much, very much, because, and they'll end up getting all those lifestyle diseases. I have seen that is happening. I mean, it's very unfortunate that 90-year-old father, you know, is alive and 65-80 years old son succumbs to myocardial infarction. It's tough. The sandwich generation is a tough challenge.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Ma'am, I have a question. These few days we have been discussing a lot about how there is a gender dimension to whatever issue. And we have seen colleagues who have also gone through similar concerns. So my concern is, why are we not advocating for a gender sensitive policy? Because every time, I don't see it as a burden. There is a lot of multiple responsibility which comes on women.
and you spoke about sandwich generation, and one can really understand the problems that they go through. So why are we not advocating for a gender sensitive policy where these issues are taken into consideration? Let's imagine if I belong to a sandwich generation, there should be some allowances given. When I say allowances, I'm not talking about concessions, but about flexi timing. You need to have an organization which is protective or proactive. But today we do not see organization which is not. Yesterday while I was traveling in train, one lady was sharing about her experience because she was taking care of her parents. 35,000 of her salary was cut because she was reporting late.
Yeah.
Now, in which generation are we in? Because crisis is going to multiply, responsibilities are multiplying, and we know we are living in a cosmos where there are other concerns, but still we are not advocating for gender-sensitive policies in our workplace. So my concern is, like-minded people like you all who have really lived the experience, we could really see the connect when you made the presentation. Can we not come together, form a group, and ensure that we work towards championing for gender-sensitive policies so that it's easier, rather than looking at it as a problem? Somewhere we have to ensure that we don't look at the problem, but see how to bring a resolve. And I feel maybe one resolve could be to support and advocate for gender-sensitive policies where these issues are really taken care of. This is just a humble reflection.
No, this is very good
side.
Because this should be done. You know, the multinationals, if they allow women to work from home, because most of the time you have computers now.
Correct.
Okay, that is something which could be, you know, easier, you know, basically easier, because you at the time you are looking after your parent, at the same time you are not compromising the work,
and
you know,
fact,
that is required.
No,
but that will be more pieces, corporate
yeah.
policy.
I think
the government keeps creating policy, the issue is implementation.
True. Thank you so much, ma'am. Right. And we could really see the connect when you made the presentation, because you have lived the experience and we really understand that. It makes so much of a difference when you talk from your own experience. Thank you so much for
that
presentation.
Thank you.